pokies, they're as Australian as meat pies and melanoma. Yet some politicians want to reform them, all because they might ruin a few thousand lives.
It's this kind of thing that makes people cynical about politics.
Senator Nick Xenophon and Independent MP Andrew Wilkie are teaming up again to tackle what they call problem gambling.
What's the problem? Are people having too much fun?
The pair are pushing for a $1 bet limit on poker machines, a cruel move which would make it take twice as long for vulnerable old people to lose their life savings. And old people's days are numbered as it is. They're also pushing for a ban on gambling ads during sports broadcasts. So in other words, they're pushing for zero ads during sports broadcasts. They're concerned about the effect of gambling advertising on children.
Some research conducted at a university has found that children as young as 8 are influenced by sports gambling ads. But 50 bucks says we can get that number down to 6 by the end of the year. Now, during this push to reform pokies, you're going to hear a lot about how gambling addiction often leads to divorce, bankruptcy, suicide. But what you're not going to hear about is how gambling addiction often gives divorced, bankrupt, suicidal people a hobby.
For example, according to Beyond Blue, 3 out of 4 people with a gambling problem are at risk of developing depression, which means 1 out of 4 people with a gambling problem is having a kick-ass time.
I like those odds.
You also might hear about the social cost to the community of problem gambling being roughly $4.7 billion a year, but that's not taking into account all the people who make money from gambling. Like politicians. Katter's Australian Party hit the jackpot with a $250,000 donation from gambling tycoon and local legend James Packer. As for the Labor Party, they got lucky by owning the most profitable poker machines in Canberra. And Liberal MP Kevin Andrews cashed out to the tune of $20,000 from Clubs New South Wales.
Now, before you say this money buys influence, a Clubs New South Wales spokeswoman has denied the contributions were intended to influence coalition gambling policy, saying they were given for no particular purpose.
Which holds up, as no particular purpose is Kevin Andrews' current role in the Turnbull government.
Ultimately though, the government needs our pokie money in the form of taxes. They're addicted to it. And you know how you help someone with an addiction? Leave them be. They'll work it out when they're ready. They're fine.